So in previous videos and in previous classes, we found the cross product rules for Cartesian coordinates. But now that we're working in magnetic fields, we're finding that we oftentimes use R, T, Z components quite often. And we might want to figure out what, say, the cross product of Z hat cross R hat will be so that we can work in easier conditions. Well, the first step to this is that we define our R hat in terms of our Cartesian coordinates, which we've done in previous classes, in previous videos. Cosine theta I hat plus sine theta J hat. Our theta hat is negative sine theta I hat plus cosine theta J hat, and our Z hat, thankfully enough, is just K hat. So what we can do then, if we're doing this cross product, is every time we see Z, we replace it with K hat. And then every time we see R, we replace it with cosine theta I hat plus sine theta J hat. So then this is going to be cosine theta of K hat cross I hat plus sine theta of K hat cross J hat. Well, we luckily enough already have written out all the rules for this. So K hat cross I hat is J hat. So Z hat cross R hat is cosine theta J hat. And then K hat cross J hat is negative I hat, so sine theta. If I do a tiny bit of rearranging, we can kind of see what we've got from this. I can rearrange this over, and I can get negative sine theta I hat plus cosine theta J hat. Have I seen this before? Is this somewhere on the screen? Absolutely. Negative sine theta I hat plus cosine theta J hat, negative sine theta I hat plus cosine theta J hat. What this means is now I have one of the rules for this. So now I know Z hat cross R hat is equal to theta hat. Awesome. So let's try another one. Let's try, of course, we're doing some targeted ones, theta hat cross Z hat. So every time I see theta hat, I'm going to replace it with sine theta I hat plus cosine theta J hat, and then I'm going to cross it with K hat, because K hat and Z hat are the same things. So then I get negative sine theta times I hat cross K hat plus cosine theta times J hat cross K hat. And I can use again the table that I have. I hat cross K hat, I hat cross K hat is a negative J hat. So I have negative sine theta times negative J hat. And then I have cosine theta, J hat cross K hat, J hat cross K hat is just I hat. Well, the two negatives cancel nicely enough. And then I see, do I have sine theta J hat plus cosine theta I hat? Might be easier to write. Theta hat cross Z hat equals cosine theta I hat, just writing this term first, plus sine theta J hat. Well, I've seen that before. That's R hat. So I can write then that theta hat cross Z hat is equal to R hat. Okay, toughest one incoming, let's do it. So we have R hat cross theta hat. Our R hat cross theta hat is going to be cosine theta I hat plus sine theta J hat crossed with negative sine theta I hat plus cosine theta J hat. Okay, so these two terms, I hat cross I hat, is zero, so we're not going to do them. We're just going to do the cross terms. So we get cosine theta times cosine theta I hat cross J hat. So we get cosine squared I hat cross J hat. Next we have sine theta J hat crossed with negative sine theta I hat. So we have negative sine squared theta J hat cross I hat. And then lastly, J hat cross J hat is zero. We're we're not going to do too much with that. Okay, I hat cross j hat is k hat. So we have cosine squared theta k hat plus j hat cross I hat is negative k hat. Negative sine squared theta, negative k hat. Well, once again, we can do some cancellation of the minus signs. That's nice enough. And we can do one last little trick. We can factor out the k hat, and we get cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta times k hat. But we have the trig identity that cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta is just equal to 1. So what we get from this is we get r hat cos theta hat is equal to z hat, right, which is also our k hat. If we want to, we can then do the inverse of these, but they just don't commute the same as the same, so we can write them again, I guess, right? We can write theta hat cross r hat is equal to negative z hat cross theta hat is equal to negative r hat, and r hat cross z hat is equal to negative theta hat. So we can use these identities for cylindrical coordinates as well as we did for Cartesian coordinates.